Welcome back to a new video about LINQ and UiPath. In the most LINQ videos I talked about data tables, how to create a LINQ query to get data from data table. In this video I want to show you something new, how to get the newest file from a directory using LINQ query. Before I start explaining the query, let me first talk about directory info and file info. What do these mean and how to use them? It's important for you, so that you can understand how to use the query in UiPath. Let's go. Assume I have the following directory, ctemp. Once we want to do something for this directory, we have to define it as directory info. It means, we define the folder as directory info, so that we can use specific functions for this directory. We can define it as follows. As you see, I have the folder path in brackets. In this way I define the folder as directory info. Directory info has specific methods and properties, for example getFiles method, to get files from this folder, or for example the property FullName, to get the full path of this directory, or many other methods and properties. Assume we have the following files in this folder. Each file is file info, but how can we get a specific file? We can do that using the following statement. As you see, I used again the same statement, and then I used the function getFiles, which is a method of directory info. In brackets I wrote exact the file name. In this way I will get only this specific file. We can also change this statement in this way. If I already used the first statement for directory info and stored it in a variable, for example di. So I can replace the first part with di. We have for file info also specific properties, which we can use to get more information about the file, like creation time, full name, extension and many other properties, or also methods like move, copy, delete and many other methods. Let's see the next file. It's also a file info. And I can get this file using the same statement, but I have only other name. And for the third one is the same. In this way we can get a specific file from the directory. But how can we get all files from directory? We can do that using this statement. As you see, I don't have the name anymore now, but I have star dot star. The first star is for the name. It means, I want to get any file, no matter what is the name. And the second star is for the extension, which means that I want to get any file, no matter which extension it has. So these stars are wildcards for the name and the extension. Let's now see how to get, for example, only the Excel files from a directory. I will use again the same statement, but now I set star for the name, which means that I want to get each file, no matter what is the name. But after the point I set the Excel extension. It means now that I want to get each Excel file from the directory, but the name is not important for me. Let's see how to get Word files, for example. We can do it also like Excel files, but here I added the Word extension. In this way I will get all Word files from the directory. This is how to define directory and read the files from it. Now we can start with LINQ query. As mentioned, I want to get the newest file from a directory. We can do that using the creation time, which means that I want to get the last created file in a directory. Or we can do that using the last write time, which means that I want to get the last modified file in a directory. I want to get the last modified file, therefore I will use the property, LastWriteTime. I have here a folder, which contains 12 different files. We have here different times, when each file is modified. The word file number 4 has the newest time, which means that I want to get it as result using LINQ query. Let's do it in UiPath. First I will add an assign activity to write the query. Here we need a variable to store the file we search for. The variable should be of type file info, because I want to get a file. It's not a standard type, therefore I will browse for it. It's system.io.fileinfo. Now I will start writing the query. I will write it in the same way, as I did always in the other LINQ videos. First we have from statement. I want to get a file from a directory, therefore I have to define a directory info and then to get the files from it. I will do it exactly the same as I showed you before. I use stars to get all files. And then I will use cast function, to get the files as file info. If you don't know how to use cast function for LINQ queries, please check the cast function video on my channel. So this statement means that I want to loop through all files in this directory. Now I will order the files using the LastWriteTime property. The order should be descending, so that I will get the newest file first, then the next one and so on. Then I will select x. X is the variable which I defined in from statement. It represents the files in the directory. Let's see what should happen until this point. First we get all files from the directory ctemp. Then we order the files using the last write time. After that we select the files one by one. The result for this query is now as follows. As you see we have a collection, which contains all files, but they are now sorted. But I don't want to get all files. I only need the newest file. So I can get it using the following function. Element at is to get an element using a specific index. In my example I use the index 0, because I want to get the first found file. This is the last modified file in the directory. That's it, very easy. Let's explain the query again. First I defined a variable x. Then I defined directory info using the folder path. I added the path directly here, but you can also use a variable instead of the path. After that I added the function getFiles, to get all files from this directory. Here I added wildcards for name and extension, because I want to get all files. After that we have cast function, to convert the files type into file info. The next statement is to sort the files using the last write time. Then I select each file. After that I select only one file as output. I will add write line activity to print out the found file. I will print the full name for example. Let's add another write line activity to print the extension for example. And I will also add write line activity to print only the name of the file. Let's run the code now, to check if I will get the correct file. As you see I have this file as output. And here I have also the extension. And also the name. Let's check in the folder, if we got the correct file. As you see, Word file number 4 is the last modified file in this folder. So it's correct. Let's now try another scenario, for example I want to get the last modified Excel file. It means I only want to check the Excel files, and get the last modified one. For this I will only change the pattern here, to get only the Excel files. And I will run the code again. As you see we have the following file as result. Let's check it in the folder. As you see, this file is the last modified one from all Excel files. This is how to get the newest file from directory using LINQ query. I hope you enjoyed the video and could learn something new. If you have any questions or video ideas, please don't hesitate to write us. Thanks for watching and have a good day.